Hi everybody, thank you to Professor Iacovello for his kind invitation to participate to this Congress. Let me introduce you about managing 300 steel under ultrasonic fatigue test at room temperature. We come from University of Michoacán in Mexico. University of Michoacán in Mexico is located about 250 kilometers northwest from Mexico City, as you see here. Now, the outline of presentation is introduction, material and experimental setup, raw material specimen of Marilyn 300, ultrasonic machine, testing condition. The second point is experimental result for Marilyn 300, ultrasonic fatigue on Marilyn 300, thermal and stress concentration, fracture analysis, and finally, conclusion. Marilyn 300 steel is widely used in modern industries such as aircraft landing gear part, as well as in fast recoil spring, high deep submarine shells, die casting dies under pressure, gas centrifuge, among others. This study is focused on the ultrasonic fatigue endurance and crack initiation and propagation investigation of Marilyn 300 steel tested at room temperature and without control of environmental humidity. Despite the industrial importance of this steel, few investigations have been developed concerning the fatigue endurance of this alloy under the ultrasonic regime. Some references are as follows. The first one is Kier et al. Influence of inclusion type on the very high cycle fatigue properties of 18 nickel Marilyn steel, Journal of Material Science, 2017. The second one is Ishii, Yagasaki, and Akagi, evaluation of gigacycle fatigue properties of some Marilyn steel by intermittent ultrasonic fatigue testing. Fatigue and Fracture of Engineering Materials and Structure, 2002. Now, the raw material, we have bought the Marilyn steel from the Fry Steel Company, which is located at California State in United States. This table presents the main mechanical properties and the chemical composition of Marilyn 300 steel. The main mechanical properties, gel stress, which is close to 1,800 megapascal, as you see here. Here we have the numerical simulation, the model numerical simulation, in order to find the natural frequency in longitudinal direction of the testing specimen. The natural frequency was close to 20 kilohertz, which was the frequency of excitation of ultrasonic fatigue machine. On the left side, we have the machining process of testing a specimen. And in the right side, we have the model numerical analysis in order to obtain the natural frequency in longitudinal direction of testing a specimen. In this case, the natural frequency found was 20,107 Hz, which was close to the natural frequency of ultrasonic fatigue machine. The final dimension of testing a specimen were 64 millimeters in length and 10 millimeters for the large diameter, and the diameter in the next section of specimen was 3 millimeters. In this slide, it's presented the ultrasonic fatigue machine, and in order to verify that the highest values of stress were located at the next section of specimen, thermographic analysis was carried out. The high values of temperature obtained by thermographic analysis were located at the next section of specimen under ultrasonic fatigue regime An stationary elastic wave is developed along the testing specimen, inducing highest values of displacement at the end of specimen and high values of stress at the next session of the specimen. The testing condition of ultrasonic fatigue tests were as follows: room temperature without control of environmental humidity and with the load ratio of air minus 1. The roughness parameter RA was measured for all specimens and comprised between 2 and 5 micrometers. Now we have the ultrasonic fatigue on margin 300. In the high values of applying load, 585 megapascal, we have between 6 and 9 million of cycles. In the middle values of applying load, 486 megapascal, we have between 40 and 60 millions of cycles. And finally, in the lowest values of applying load, 389 megapascal, we have between 5 and 900 of million of cycles. The thermal analysis of stress concentration showed that the highest values of stress concentration from physical point of view are located at the next section of specimen. This image was obtained by thermographic analysis, which is similar for numerical analysis. From numerical analysis, the high values is located at the next section of testing. Now, concerning fracture analysis, superficial fracture paths on margin 300 with the lowest applying load, 389 megapascal, show very low thermal effect along the superficial crack. As applying load is increased, a clear temperature degradation is observed along the superficial crack path. Figure 8 corresponds to 486 megapascal and figure B corresponding to 585 megapascal. Corresponding the fractures analysis, fracture surface a high applying load, 585 megapascal, the crack initiation and propagation are associated with a metallic inclusion which is located at the center of the circular zone. This circular zone decreases as the applying load increases. At the middle value of applying load, 486 megapascal, the circular zone containing the crack initiation and propagation inclusion is higher compared to the previous case. This behavior must be attributed to the fact that at a lower load levels, the slow crack propagation is amplified and covers a larger area of the total crack propagation area. Finally, for the low applying load, 389 megapascal, the crack initiation and propagation present the same behavior, nevertheless, the circular zone associated with the metallic inclusion cover a larger surface of total fracture surface. In conclusion, ultrasonic fatigue endurance results has been obtained on the margin 300 steel at room temperature and reversed load ratio R minus 1. Ultrasonic fatigue endurance is close to 8 million of cycle for the high applying load, 585 megapascal, whereas this value increases to 6 to 900 million of cycle for the low applying load, 389 megapascal. Superficial fracture path is characterized by a thermal effect near the crack, which grows up with the applying load. Fracture origin is frequently associated with a metallic inclusion inside the material. Circular zones of crack initiation and propagation are observed around the crack initiation inclusion. This zone increases as the applying load decreases. Finally, the observed low cycling strength compared to the very high static strength of this steel may be related to a cyclic softening and ground of precipitate during the cyclic loading. Thank you for your attention.